Hi. For this section, we will actually look how to make the most of the text you have encoded in the previous one. So we started to see how we can display it for other people to look at it. In fact, why is a good idea to look at the text rendered in a nice way? First of all, because it's helpful for you to correct typo. When you have elements around that, perhaps it's difficult for you to focus on the text and make sure that you have transcribed it accurately. But also sometimes you want to show the people your work, and maybe they're not so familiar with the TI and XML. So you want to give them a version that they are able to read without having headaches. It's not a good idea to use the visualization for actually editing, as we will see, but it's good for correcting and check what you have done so far. There are, in fact, different types of visualization you can apply on top of an XML file. The first of all is called CSS, Cascading Style Sheet. It is very powerful, but limited in the meantime. It's the one that is used for most of the web pages you see on the internet, but it can be applied also on the XML. As I said, it's a bit less powerful than it is for the HTML of the web pages, and is definitely less powerful of the XSL, Extensible Style Sheet language, which is able to take your XML and transform it into something else, like an HTML file, a PDF file, an ODT OpenOffice file, an EPUB file. So it is very powerful, but it's also not the easiest thing to learn. There is one extra module on this course about XSLT. So if you feel brave and you like what you're doing, it's perhaps the case you take it and see how that works in practice. To begin with, in reality, we can use some standardized style sheet that the TI develops and distributes for people to use them freely. You can use them within any software, but you can use particularly within Oxygen, that is able to transform your XML file using the material provided by the TI. For Oxygen, you can visualize actually in two ways, using either the CSS or the XSL. For the CSS, it's easily done. You open your XML file within Oxygen and you click on the author view. We shall see in a moment how it works. For the XSLT, you can do the same, but it's a bit more complicated. You have to open a pop-up, but that allows you to transform your file in different ways. Shall we see how it works? I open now my Oxygen, and I have here the file I have just encoded. So it is my Gettysburg address, my Hey copy, that I have encoded in just last time. You see at the bottom of the screen, you have text, grid, and author. If I click on the author that way, you see that the text is presented nice and clean. There is no elements here, nothing on view. There is no attributes. Everything is presented as if it was in your normal word processor. So as you see, it's a very great thing to have, because it allows you to control that your transcription is well done. But you can see no elements. No elements means danger. If you don't see your elements, you may actually be tempted to do the overlapping, which is forbidden, as you remember. So this is good for checking, not for encoding. But if you want to transform properly it into something else, then you can do it as well. On the top of Oxygen, you see this little tool with a little arrow that is where my mouse is, and say configure transformation scenario. If you click on that, you have a pop-up that opens. And you see here that there is several options: typify XML, PDF, EPUB, Docs, and ODT. Those are all the possibilities offered by the style sheet produced by the TI. I click on the XHTML, which is the one I want to see now, and I click also on the PDF. In this way, my process will produce automatically both of them. And I click Apply Associated on the button on the pop-up. Now, if you're lucky, it should work. And by magic, you see my HTML file has been opened within my browser. And if we wait long enough, we shall see the PDF also being presented to you. It's taking a little bit longer because it's a bit more difficult to produce a PDF with respect to that. But eventually it will come. Et voilà! At the end of the waiting time, which wasn't too bad at the end, we have the PDF that has been created for you by the TI. So these are the tools that you can use to visualize your files once you have encoded them.